So human beings are the subject of criminal law. In that sense, we have to observe what are the subject of international law. Because we seen earlier, the state, or while defining the concept of international law, majority authors, majority jurists emphasized on the international law is a law relating to states, law regulating the relations between state. That's what state is a primary subject of public international law particularly. But it is not so, because international law was developed in the context of developing technology, developed industrial revolution, other research, other things. So the horizons of the international law were widened up to major extent, and now it covers individual as well as non-state entities, those who are not state but they were group, public corporations or MNCs we can say. And most importantly, international organizations, they are having the major share in the development of international law. They were also the subject of international law. But in this module, we are going to see in detail the how these subjects are. Yes, so here we have to see the meaning and definition of state, because state being the primary subject, we have to observe what are the attributes of the state, or who qualifies for the concept of state. That's what here we have to see, the kinds of different state in international law, like sovereign, semi-sovereign, protectorate, vassal, trust, holy see, neutralized state, etc. Secondly, we have to observe the individual as a subject and object of international law. Object in the sense, state is an abstract entity, state act through individuals only. So state is composed of individual. So here individual is becoming object as well as subject of international law, because prime minister of particular nation or president of particular nation is an individual. So thereby individual can be an object, as well as international law regulates the human being of individuals in many respect. So individual is a subject also. So in that sense, we have to see. Individual, please mute your mic. Someone left his mic on. I request him to mute your mic. All state to mute their mics. Sunil Surav say, mute your mic. Yes. So we have to see how individual as a subject and object of international law, and further the role of the multinational corporations in the development of international law, role and status, whether they are subject of international law, whether international law can impose right and duties upon multinational corporations, because multinational, the word itself suggests they are working in more than one nations. In many cases, or in almost all cases, they having their registered office in one nation and they work in several other nations. In such cases, the differences may arose that which state will have jurisdiction over that multinational corporation. So those aspects we have to study. Yes. So we will start with the what subject is. So subject is a concept upon which the rules or law confers right and capacity and imposes duties and responsibility. So subject are those concepts, those entities upon which law confers right and capacity. Janchavar kaydane hakka ani kartavya takli jatat. बंधन टाकली जातात, सक्षमता टाकली जाते, त्या सगळ्या प्रकारांना सब्जेक्ट म्हणायचे. सो वेअर एज एन ऑब्जेक्ट एन्जॉयज अँड इज नॉट बर्डन बाय सच कॉम्पिटन्स, परंतु जे ते ड्युटीज टाकतात त्यांना ऑब्जेक्ट म्हटलं जातं, त्यांच्यावर एवढ्या जबाबदाऱ्या नसतात जसं स्टेट. सो द लॉ कमांड्स इट सब्जेक्ट, बट इट मिअरली रेग्युलेट द यूज अँड डिस्पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. सो ऑर्डिनरीली इट्स रूल्स आर फॉर स्टेट्स. Generally, it is for states who entered into treaties with each other and are therefore bound by its provisions. So we have to observe firstly what is meant by state, to whom we can call state. That's what we have to study, the meaning and definition of state. Yes. So state is being the main subject of international law. It is very difficult to define the term state, but certain jurists have made their endeavor to this respect. Now take note of the one fact that you studied concept of state under constitutional law, isn't it? That concept of state is different from the concept of state we are studying under international law. That concept of state is applicable to, or what that state is, where you studied concept of state earlier, state in the context of municipal law, particularly Constitution of India, what state is? Because they are empowered to law. They are amenable to fundamental rights, territory of India. State as per Indian Constitution, not as per international law. What I am reminding you, because you should not confused with the state under Constitution and state under international law. Here, state under international law means territory of India, nation, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, China, these are state. But under Constitution of India, particularly part 3rd, you studied the concept of state. That state means, yes, any example of the state which you studied under Constitution, under article, which article of the Constitution of India provides for the concept of state? That is for part 3rd and 4th. Yes, article 12, Ashish. But that concept of state should not be confused with this concept of state. That state is applicable to part 3rd, 4th, government and authorities. Yes. Even local authorities. So that is government and parliament of India, government and parliament of state legislature, local authorities and other authorities within the territory of India. So they are amenable to fundamental right and they are empowered to make law. The other persons cannot make law, because after article 12 you studied article 13 under constitution, I am saying, wherein concept of law is defined. Both articles are linked, because those who are state, only they can enter the law. Whatever said by others cannot be a law, particularly for the purpose of fundamental right. Recently, you might have been read one judgment of the High Court, High Court of Bombay. They refused one writ petition in connection with the state, and they said that is not law. That doesn't have a force of law. Who are they? Had you read the news? Yes. बातम्या असल्या काय इतक्यात एक हायकोर्टने एक पिटिशन एंटरटेन करायला नकार दिला आणि सांगितलं की त्याला लॉ म्हणत नाही. त्यांनी केलेल्या नियमाला, त्यांनी जे रिझोल्युशन पास केलंय त्याला लॉ म्हणत नाही, कारण दे आर नॉट स्टेट. कारण इकडे कशाला बघतोय आपण, ते त्या दोन्ही गोष्टीमध्ये कन्फ्युजन होऊ नये आणि ती पण गोष्ट क्लिअर होईल तुमची. वन ऑफ दी असोसिएशन फ्रॉम मुंबई इश्यूड अन रिझोल्युशन. येस, शिव केबल नेटवर्क बीइंग अन असोसिएशन ऑफ प्रायव्हेट पर्सन्स, दे पास द रिझोल्युशन अँड बॅन रिपब्लिक टीव्ही फ्रॉम टेलिकास्टिंग थ्रू दॅट पर्टिक्युलर cable. Against this, the Republic TV approached to the High Court for violation of freedom of speech and expression. The court stated that This freedom of speech and expression is available against state. And this resolution is not a law as per Article 13. Law can be made only by state, and this particular organization of private person is not a state. Therefore, this petition cannot be entertained, cannot be accepted, and directions cannot be issued. You may approach to the government, or other alternative remedies available with you. So this writ jurisdiction cannot be exercised. So in that context, the state under Article 12 of the Constitution is different. Even municipal corporation, granted colleges can be a state. There, here, only nations are state. So let's come here under international law what state is. This is only for the sake of clarity that the state under Constitution, particularly Article 12, is different, and here under international law it is different. So yes, now we will see certain definitions given by the jurist of state, Salmond. This name is not new to you. Even contract was also defined by Salmond. So state is a community of people. लोकांचा समूह. पॉलिटिकल सायन्स वाले असतील त्यांनी ऐकलेले असतील या गोष्टी. स्टेट इज अ कम्युनिटी ऑफ पीपल विच हॅज बीन एस्टॅब्लिश्ड फॉर सम ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह सच एज इंटरनल ऑर्डर अँड एक्सटर्नल सिक्युरिटी. सालमंडनं दोनच फंक्शन स्टेटचे घेतलेत, अंतर्गत सुव्यवस्था आणि परकीय आक्रमणापासून संरक्षण. हे फंक्शन असणारा लोकांचा समूह म्हणजे स्टेट. ओपेनहाइम डिफाइन स्टेट. The existence of state is possible only when people of state have settled under highest government authority and habitually follow its order. Two components were laid down by Oppenheim for the state. There must be establishment of highest government authority, and people are in the habit of obedience to that particular authority. This system, if anywhere, then this system is called as a state. Then Professor H. L. A. Hart, he says state can be referred in two ways. First, a population, Lok Sankhya, inhabiting in a territory, live under that form of ordered government provided by a legal system, which its characteristics, structure of legislature, court and primary rules. So he talks about the creation of state created by constitution. It says there must be a population. That population is living in particular territory, and that territory is under a government system. This government system having certain characteristics such as legislature, court, and they are having primary rules. So the government enjoys a vaguely defined degree of independence. And secondly, there must be an enormous independence, vaguely defined independence of the government. Government la swatantra asel tithe kutlyahi goshti karnyache, kutlyahi kayde karnyache. So that concept of entity can be called as a state as per H.L. A. Hart. Then Lawrence says state is a society which is politically organized, and its members are bound with each other by being under some central authority, and most of the people automatically follow the rules of this central authority. Again, here you will find overlapping between the definitions of different authors. They are saying same thing but in a different languages because they are jurists. So stark, an ideal definition of the state is not possible. But in the modern period, it is finally settled as to what are the essential elements of state. Yes. So again, here the correct answer is given by Stark here also, in the definition also. Here Stark says the state cannot be defined exhaustively, but what can be defined? The essential attribute of state. Avashyak babi sangitlya jau shaktat ki rashtra hi sankalpana asnyasathi ya ya goshti asne avashyak aahe. Mag ya goshti ja samudayakade astil te rashtra असतील आणि ते इंटरनॅशनल लॉ त्यांना लागू असेल अल्टिमेटली. सो व्हॉट द इसेन्शियल्स ऑफ स्टेट ॲज पर स्टार्क. लॅटर द those essentials were codified by a convention. So we will move towards essential elements of state given by a codified international law. That is the Montevideo. Montevideo is a place. Montevideo Convention on Right and Duties of States, 1933. This convention was adopted only to define the right and duties of state. What state and what state possess? What kind of right and duties state has? Article 1 of this convention says that the state as a person of international law should possess the following qualifications. या गोष्टी स्टेटकडे असणं आवश्यक आहे. या असतील तर त्या स्टेटला स्टेट म्हणता येईल इंटरनॅशनल लॉ साठी, त्या समुदायाला स्टेट म्हणता येईल. पहिलं आहे परमनंट पॉप्युलेशन. सो पॉप्युलेशन मस्ट नॉट बी वॉन्डरिंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर, दे मस्ट बी सेटल्ड. सो ट्राईब्स कॅनॉट बी कन्सिडर्ड ॲज अ स्टेट ॲज पर धिस कन्व्हेन्शन बिकॉज दे वेर नॉट सेटल्ड ॲट वन प्लेस. सो परमनंट पॉप्युलेशन. Secondly, a defined territory. Defined need not be have a demarcated boundaries, but at least they can define, yes, this is our territory. Third, they had a government, be it constitutionally or by other method, democracy, autocracy, etc. Depends upon the will and wishes of the people of that particular territory. So government, and lastly, capacity to enter into relations with other states. इतर राष्ट्राशी संबंध प्रस्थापित करण्याची सक्षमता असेल तर ते समुदाय हे राष्ट्र असू शकतात as per article 1 of Montevideo Convention on Right and Duties of States, 1933. So the famous jurist Holland has added one more essential element here, that is civilization. In the modern context, apart from these four, there must be a civilization. Nagrikaran झालेलं असणं आवश्यक आहे आणि मग त्या समुदायाला राष्ट्र म्हणायचं. Now with these characteristics, number of populations, communities are there and they were state. They are having now in modern international law, all are having their own constitutions, and constitution defines how that particular community will act with their own subject as well as with foreign nations. So we will move towards the kinds of different state in international law. So for the purposes of international law, state may be divided into following kinds. First, sovereign state, म्हणजे ते सार्वभौम राष्ट्र असतात, त्यांचा निर्णय घेण्याची त्यांना पूर्ण क्षमता असते. ते कुठल्याही राष्ट्रावर अवलंबून नसतात. इंडिया, चायना, यूएसए, यूके, सॉवरिन स्टेट्स. सो इंडिपेंडंट स्टेट्स आर फुल्ली सॉवरिन मेंबर्स ऑफ द फॅमिली ऑफ नेशन्स. दे आर टर्म्ड इन इंटरनॅशनल लॉ एज सॉवरिन स्टेट्स. दे आर द नॉर्मल टाईप ऑफ सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल लॉ अँड एक्झरसाइज, येस, नो कंट्रोल एक्झरसाइज बाय द अदर स्टेट्स ओव्हर देअर इंटरनल अफेअर्स. So they are the normal type of subjects of international law and exercise undivided authority over all persons and property within their borders and are independent of direct control by the other power. That's what the process of extradition is. Once the state is sovereign, you cannot enter into their territory even to take your own property. You have to seek their permission. So the process of seeking permission is extradition, to arrest the fugitive offenders from one nation. So sovereign states are by international usages entitled to certain privileges and immunities. So such as they are entitled to send diplomatic agents to other states and of receiving their representatives in return. So they entered into treaties on their own name with other states. They meet at international conferences on the basis of perfect equality. In short, there is no party to intermeddle in their relations with other state. Itar rashtrashi sambandh prasthapit karnyasathi kutlahi interpoler त्यांना लागत नाही, मध्यस्थी राष्ट्र लागत नाही. दे आर सॉवरिन ऑन देअर ओन, दे कॅन डिसाइड देअर फॉरेन पॉलिसी ऑन देअर ओन. सो स्टेट लाईक इंडिया, फ्रान्स, युनायटेड किंगडम एक्सेट्रा, नंबर ऑफ स्टेट्स आर सॉवरिन. नाउ सेकंड कॅटेगरी दॅट इज सेमी सॉवरिन, ऑफकोर्स रिवर्स टू दी सॉवरिन. सो कॉम्प्रोमाइजेस इन सर्टन आस्पेक्ट्स दे वेर कॉल्ड एज सेमी सॉवरिन. सो दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज डिपेंडंट स्टेट, दे वेर डिपेंडंट ऑन अदर. दे इंडिपेंडंटली हॅव ओनली अ लिमिटेड कॅपॅसिटी फॉर फॉरेन रिलेशन्स अँड आर इम्परफेक्ट सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल. सो लाईक इनिशियली स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू अँड काश्मीर आफ्टर इंडिपेंडन्स दे रिलाइड अपॉन इंडिया फॉर एक्सटर्नल अफेअर्स अँड डिफेन्स. लॅटर दे मर्ज्ड इन टू इंडिया. सो दे आर सब्जेक्ट टू द ऑथॉरिटी ऑफ वन ऑर मोर अदर स्टेट्स, इवन हाँगकाँग. दॅट वी विल सी लॅटर द स्टेटस ऑफ हाँगकाँग, तैवान, सेव्हरल अदर्स दॅट वी विल सी. सो द आयडिया ऑफ सेमी सॉवरिन नेसेसरीली इम्प्लाईज रिलेशन बिटवीन सुपेरियर स्टेट अँड अन इन्फिरियर स्टेट ऑर सब्जेक्ट स्टेट. सो सुपेरियर स्टेट कॅन लिगली इम्पोज इट्स विल अँड द इन्फिरियर स्टेट इज लिगली कंपेल्ड टू सबमिट टू दॅट विल. Now, the third kind of state is protectorate. Now, there is overlapping between protectorate, semi-sovereign, vassal, etc. So, third is protectorate. Because the nature of agreement between two states, त्याच्यावर अवलंबून असेल protectorate दिलंय का semi-sovereign आहे काय, कारण त्याच्यासाठी treaty होते दोन राष्ट्रामध्ये आणि त्याच्यावरून त्या राष्ट्राचं स्वरूप निश्चित होतं. जसं हाँगकाँग आणि चायनामध्ये आणि ब्रिटनमध्ये ट्रिटी आहे, त्याच्यामुळे ती ट्रिटी आत्ता 2041 काहीतरी संपुष्टात येईल. त्याच्यामुळे तुम्हाला दिसेल हाँगकाँगमध्ये वेगवेगळे आंदोलनं चालू आहे. वी विल सी देअर. सो थर्ड इज प्रोटेक्टोरेट स्टेट. दॅट इज इन द केस ऑफ प्रोटेक्टोरेट अ वीक स्टेट सीक्स द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ अ स्ट्रॉंग स्टेट बाय द कन्क्लुजन ऑफ अ ट्रिटी with the result that the important international business is left to the protecting state. सरळ छोटं राष्ट्र मोठ्या राष्ट्राकडून संरक्षण घेतं इंटरनॅशनल पॉलिसीच्या बाबतीत आणि त्यांना सरेंडर करतं. त्यावेळी प्रोटेक्टोरेट आणि प्रोटेक्टिंग असे दोन स्टेट तयार होतात. प्रोटेक्टिंग ज्यांनी प्रोटेक्शन दिलंय आणि प्रोटेक्टोरेट ज्यांनी घेतलंय. सो The protecting state exercises varying measures of control over external relations and sometimes over internal affairs of the weak state depending upon the provision of the treaty. त्यांनी ट्रीटी साईन करून काय त्यांच्यात देवाणघेवाण झाली आहे त्या तरतुदींवर या गोष्टी अवलंबून असतात. सो ओपेनहॅम कॉल्स द रिलेशनशिप अ काइंड ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल गार्डियनशिप. सो दिस अरेंजमेंट वेर नेम्ड बाय ओपेनहॅम as international guardianship. So it makes the idea clear about the protectorate state. It nothing but the guardianship given by one state to another. Palakatva svikarana. So the example is Sikkim earlier. Now it is complete part of India. But earlier, yes, India, Bhutan, Sikkim. Sikkim is now state, but earlier it was a protectorate state of India. So Sikkim, which is a small state embedded in the Himalayas earlier under the direct control of the government of India in 1905 and continued to be British protectorate since then. Karan 1905, India is a colony of Britishers. Therefore, it was continued. On December 5, 1950, the government of India entered into a treaty with Sikkim whereby the latter continues to be a protectorate of India. 1950 nantar matra British gele ani bhartakade protectorate mhanun aale Sikkim. On April 23, 1975, the Constitution Amendment Bill was approved by both the houses of parliament by giving the status of full-fledged state to the Sikkim as demanded by the people of Sikkim. Nantar mag Sikkim cha पॉप्युलेशनच्या मागणीनुसार सिक्कीमला भारतात मर्ज करण्यात आला आणि भारतातलं एक स्वतंत्र राज्य हे सिक्कीम झालं. सो इट बिकेम 22nd स्टेट ऑफ इंडियन युनियन, बट अर्लियर इट वॉज अ प्रोटेक्टोरेट स्टेट. सेम थिंग इज विथ द भूतान. सो भूतान इज अ प्रोटेक्टोरेट ऑफ यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ द ट्रीटी कंक्लूडेड बिटवीन टू स्टेट्स इन द इयर 1949. सो the india has to advise, govern and control and regulate the bhutan's foreign relationship and external affairs. So in 1971 the bhutan was admitted as a member of united nations. Even after admission to the united nations under the 1949 treaty, bhutanese external affairs are to be conducted with the guidance of the government of india. So lot of examples can be found in the world where in many states, particularly in Europe, they were protectorate. Similar, the fourth kind is vassal, VASSAL, vassal state. A vassal state is one which is completely under the suzerainty of another state. It has no position in international law. So now more एक्सटेन्सिव्ह दॅन प्रोटेक्टोरेट. प्रोटेक्टोरेटमध्ये तरी काही गोष्टी, जसं युनायटेड नेशनचं सभासद होणं हे भूतानच्या हातात आहे स्वतंत्रपणे, पण सुझर्निटी म्हणजे ऍब्सोल्यूट कंट्रोल ओव्हर एक्सटर्नल अफेअर्स, दॅट इज वॅसल कम्प्लिटली. सो द सुझेरियन ऍब्झॉर्ब्स ऑल दी फंक्शन्स ऑफ दी वॅसल स्टेट. अ वॅसल हॅज नो राईट ऑफ डिक्लेअरिंग वॉर नॉर ऑफ मेकिंग अलायन्सेस विथ फॉरेन पॉवर्स. Yes, Tibet. So, in its foreign affairs, the vassal state possesses no power and all its foreign policies are governed by the state of which it is a vassal state. So, there are, however, instances where vassal states have maintained certain external relations in, and in such cases, they have a limited international personality, depends upon the another state. So, we will see what the difference between protectorate and vassal. In case of protectorate, it entrusts its matter of security, defense and external affairs of another state. Three things: security, defense, external affairs. But in vassal state, it is autonomous in its internal affairs but completely depend upon the other state for in external affairs. Internal autonomy tanna asel, परंतु एक्सटर्नल अफेअरसाठी मात्र पूर्णपणे दुसऱ्या राष्ट्रावर अवलंबून असणे. सेकंडली, इन प्रोटेक्टोरेट मे बिकम अ मेंबर ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल कम्युनिटी बट हियर दे कॅनॉट रिगार्डेड ॲज अ मेंबर ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल कम्युनिटी, मीन्स युनायटेड नेशन्स ऑर्गनायझेशन हियर. देन सॉवरनिटी वॉज टेकन बाय कंट्री ऑफ विच इट बिकम्स प्रोटेक्टोरेट. इकडं वॅसल स्टेट इज सेमी सॉवरिंग. So treaty entered into by the protecting state is not binding upon the protectorate. Here vassal state is bound by the treaty entered into by protectorate state. Ikda matra treaty bandhankarak asel, tikda bandhankarak nasel. Yes, they cannot enter unless their protectorate state allows, or through their protectorate state they can entered into external relationship. Whatever external affairs are there, that has to be seen by the another state under whose vassal they are. Now fifth kind of territory, that is trust territories. So for this the provision was there in United Nations Charter. Article 77 of the Charter provides for trustship system अशा सगळ्या राष्ट्रांसाठी. सो टेरिटरीज नाव हेल्ड अंडर मॅन्डेट. थोडक्यात जिकडे गव्हर्नमेंट एस्टॅब्लिश झालेलं नाहीये त्या सगळ्या ठिकाणी युनायटेड नेशन्स हे कारभार पाहते. इन शॉर्ट, त्याच्यासाठी एक सेपरेट सिस्टीम आहे युनायटेड नेशन ऑर्गनची, ट्रस्टशिप सिस्टम. So territories which may be detached from enemy states as a result of the Second World War and not yet settled, and territories voluntarily placed under the system by states रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर देअर ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. राज्यानं स्वतःलाच युनायटेड नेशनच्या स्वाधीन केलं असेल की तुम्ही येऊन इकडं कारभार पहा, इकडं स्टेबल गव्हर्नमेंट नाही वगैरे. अँड द ट्रस्टशिप सिस्टम डज नॉट अप्लाय टू टेरिटरीज विच हॅव बिकम मेंबर्स ऑफ द युनायटेड नेशन्स, कारण दे आर इंडिपेंडेंट. Then they neutralized. They were not dependent on their own. So they take the guarantee from another state. Whatever you want to do, do on behalf of us. We will remain neutral. Such states are neutralized. So a neutralized state is one whose independence and political as well as territorial integrity are guaranteed permanently by a collective agreement of great powers, subject to the condition that the particular state concerned will never take up arms against another state except to defend itself and will never into a war. त्या राष्ट्राने कधी युद्धामध्ये सहभागी व्हायचे नाही, कधी हातात शस्त्र घ्यायचे नाही, या अटीवर त्यांचे पॉलिटिकल किंवा अदर गोष्टी या सरेंडर्ड केलेले असतात आणि त्यांना गॅरंटी दिलेली असते मोठ्या राष्ट्रांनी की तुमचं संरक्षण आम्ही करू, तुमच्या वतीने आम्ही युद्ध करू. सो स्टेट्स हुज इंडिपेंडन्स अँड न्यूट्रॅलिटी आर गॅरंटीड फॉर ऑल फ्युचर टाइम बाय अ ट्रीटी इज नोन ॲज न्यूट्रलाइज्ड स्टेट्स. सो द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ न्यूट्रलायझेशन इज टू प्रोटेक्ट वीक स्टेट्स, जे सक्षम राष्ट्र नाही आहेत, दुर्बळ राष्ट्र आहेत, त्यांना युद्धासाठी याच्यासाठी आधीच रिसोर्सेस नाही आहेत, त्यांच्या वतीनं मोठ्या राष्ट्रांना त्यांना संरक्षण द्यायचे सर. सो टू प्रोटेक्ट वीक स्टेट्स फ्रॉम देअर पॉवरफुल नेबर्स, बट नो स्टेट कॅन बी न्यूट्रलाइज विदाउट इट्स कन्सेंट. ऑफकोर्स कन्सेंट इज रिक्वायर्ड. वॅसल स्टेट वी हॅड सीन ऑलरेडी. वॅसल स्टेट इज अ स्टेट completely under the autonomy of another state for external affairs. Protectorate state आणि vassal state मध्ये हा फरक असेल. Protectorate state ला तरी थोडेफार अधिकार असतील आंतरराष्ट्रीय पातळीवर, पण vassal state चे आंतरराष्ट्रीय व्यवहार हे पूर्णपणे दुसऱ्या राष्ट्राच्या हातात असतील, ज्या राष्ट्राचे ते vassal states आहेत. vassal म्हणजे जहाजाच्या प्रमाणे ती उपमा दिलेली आहे की समुद्रात जर एखादं जहाज असेल तर बाकीच्यांवर त्यांना अवलंबून असतं बाहेर जाण्यासाठी, तसं ते वेसल स्टेट आहे की ते राष्ट्र पूर्णपणे दुसऱ्या राष्ट्रावर अवलंबून असतं एक्सटर्नल अफेअरच्या बाबतीत. इंटरनलच्या बाबतीत जे काय करायचं आहे ते वेसल स्टेट्सला पॉवर असेल, पण आंतरराष्ट्रीय संबंधासाठी संपूर्ण दुसऱ्या राष्ट्रावर अवलंबून राहणे, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ वेसल स्टेट. येस, इज इट क्लिअर नाऊ? Yes, so the example of neutralized states were Switzerland, Australia, Congo. Other state we will see tomorrow, that is the last kind is remain, that is Vatican City or Holy See. This is the religious state having the least territory, sagalyat kami loksankhya ani prant aslele rashtra jagatle, that we will see tomorrow. Okay.